Hello everyone, welcome to AWS Tutorials. In AWS Tutorials, we provide workshops and exercises to learn about AWS services. In workshop and exercises, you implement certain scenario, and when you implement the scenario, you learn about certain AWS services. All these workshops and scenarios are uploaded to our website, aws-dozo.com. So today we are going to talk about a new feature which got released as a part of AWS Glue is that Glue ETL job can now handle streaming data. And then we are going to learn about it. Okay. So if I look at the traditional way, the way Glue used to work, Glue was you were able to create an ETL job in Glue, which can source data from, say, S3 bucket or any kind of JDBC, ODBC sources like your relational databases, be it SQL Server, MySQL, Postgres, Oracle, name it. It can also source data from JDBC sources like Redshift. Even you can call API because you can write your job inside Glue using Python shell script as well. So it was able to source data from these sources and can also upload data or update data to similar sources like to S3 bucket or databases or APIs. So this has been this is the job of Glue job is an ETL job, and this it has been doing for quite some time. And such job actually you can either schedule at certain frequency, or you can also start based on the event. You can also configure it as a part of the workflow. Yeah, all those things you can do. Then recently, AWS announces that now they support streaming data for the Glue, and that changes it's still an ETL job, but that changes the nature of the Glue job a bit. So now with the new feature, actually Glue can start reading data from streaming data sources like Kafka or Kinesis, and it can still write to destinations like S3 bucket, APIs, or databases. Now, the way the nature of the job changes over here is that earlier Glue job was either scheduled, or it was run on demand, or it was run based on the event. Now, Glue job, when dealing with streaming data, it runs as when you start the job, it runs as a continuous job. So it keeps running because your streaming data. And the way the streaming data works is that it keeps coming at the data sources like Kinesis or Kafka, and then Glue will keep reading data from there and doing the ETL job to the destination. Now you can say that fair enough. I can do the similar things with construct like Lambda. I can put Lambda as a way to read data from Kinesis data stream as a part of Kinesis data. Data stream firehose, pipeline. I can put Lambda, which can read data from Kinesis and write. Yes, definitely you can do that. I'm not denying that. But the people who use Glue job, they know that when you use Glue job, you can write your PySpark script. You can use PySpark transformation, and also you can handle big data. Using data frames or dynamic frames. If you want to use those kind of construct into your ETL jobs, big data constructs, PySpark kind of thing, then you will prefer to use Glue as a way to process the data than Lambda. So it is quite important and significant that Glue supports streaming data, because now you can do PySpark-based, Spark-based analysis and transformation of the data, even on the streaming data. So the way it works, guys, simply said, it can source data from Kinesis and Kafka. When you start the Glue job, it always runs. And then, it keeps looking for data. And when the data comes, it simply processes the data and uploads to the destination you have configured for. So what are we going to build today to see this whole thing working? It's a pretty straightforward scenario. We'll first go ahead and create a Kinesis data stream. And then we'll write a glue job, which can read data from this Kinesis data stream and upload to S3 bucket. And we are doing simple out-of-box transformation right now, which is converting a JSON file into a CSV file. Then what we have done is, in order to upload data to Kinesis data stream, we have done a simulation where we will go and configure an IoT device. And then we'll use MQTT client, which comes as a part of IoT code, to publish data to Kinesis data stream. And then that will take care of the taken care of by the glue job. And if you look at this is really how a realistic scenario will work. In most of realistic scenario, you will have IoT device, which is sending the streaming data, and the data is then using IoT code and rules routed to Kinesis data stream. And then you have a glue job looking into data stream and then transforming into some kind of destination format and uploading it to one of the destination locations, like the S3 or Redshift, things like that. So this is a scenario we are going to build today as a part of the workshop. So we'll go to the workshop, and the URL of the workshop has been provided in the description below. If you click on this URL, you will find that we have provided step-by-step process to configure AWS services, to create AWS services, to implement the whole scenario end-to-end. Okay, so feel free to use this link and run this workshop by your own in your own time, and learn how you can use Glue and Kinesis data stream and IoT to make it work together to do a streaming data processing. But let me take you through the steps of this workshop and what you have to do in order to implement the whole scenario. So jumping onto the workshop, there are many workshop and exercises in our website, aws-dozo.com. And the one which we have opened up right now is the Glue streaming one. And then if you click on this button, it will start a link. It will start the workshop. And this workshop has got a good 10 steps. So let's go through it one by one. So first is a prerequisite, where all we are saying that you need to have an AWS account with administrative access to perform this workshop. And if you don't have such account, feel free to create one trial version. And we have provided a link for the same. In the next step, we create certain role. You know that in AWS, if services have to talk to each other, then these services are authorized using the roles. So we are going to create two roles, and one role will be used by IoT to perform the actions for on other services, and one will be used by Glue job to perform other services. So we'll starting with the first role. So we'll create two roles, Dozo Glue role and Dozo IoT role. So we're starting with the first one, which is the Glue role. So we start with creation of the role. We associate with the Glue, and then on the next side, on the next one, we provide access to Power Azure access. And you might say, hey, it's too much. And yes, it is too much. But we try to keep it simple here, because this job, this will be used by the Glue job, which is going to call S3, Kinesis, catalog, many things. So instead of making it very complex by providing individual services or specific services, I just give a blanket a large access to it just for the workshop purpose. But if you are going for production deployment, of course you want to go for very specific permission, and you should go for it. Okay, so we give permission to this particular role, and then we give it a nice name, Dozo Glue role, and create the role. So role is created. So after our Dozo role has been created, now we create the next role, which is the IoT role. So similar way, you go and create an IoT role. You select IoT as a service, and then you say, I want to use it to allow IoT to call other AWS services on your behalf. Then It comes with pre-configured policies, this role, so you don't need to do anything. Simply move next, give this role a nice name, like Dozo IT role, and then simply create the role. And it has got these three permissions by default. Okay, so few roles comes with pre-configured permissions, and few you have to. So we created the role. Now, once the role is created, let's go and create the Kinesis data stream, because this is the place where your streaming data will be published. And then Glue Catalog has to read data from and write to S3 bucket after the transformation. So this step is pretty straightforward. We simply go and create a Kinesis data stream. Then you give this one a nice name called Dojo Stream, and again, number of shards as one, because I'm not looking for very high throughput here. Just for it will be, in fact, even one is will be too much. But yeah, you can't go below one. You go for one shard, and then I simply go and create the Kinesis data stream. So once my data stream has been created, now next step, create a bucket, which works as a destination. So when my Glue job runs, it reads data from Kinesis data stream and writes to S3 bucket. So we simply go and create a Dojo data Dojo data stream as a bucket. Yeah, simple. And we also create a script folder under the bucket, because when we create a Glue job, it needs a folder where it can keep its generated script. So I said, why not simply create a folder under this bucket and simply, you know, I'll configure this folder to be used by the Glue job to keep the scripts. So simple. So created the folder, created the bucket. Now let's go and create the publisher, the guy who is going to create the data, and that is a device. So it's pretty straightforward in this case. We simply go to the IoT core. We first create an IoT policy. We need to create an IoT policy because when we register a device is then associated with a certificate for authentication, and then certificate is associated with a policy for authorization. So the starting point always is policy. So you go and create a policy first, and we're giving it all kind of actions to this policy, and then after that, we simply register the device. We give this device a nice name, say Dojo Device 1. And then we generate the certificate. We activate the certificate. And then after that, it says, hey, do you want to attach policy to the certificate? Because certificate is nothing unless some authorization has been provided to the certificate. So simply attach the previous policy to this certificate so that now this thing has got permission to be able to say publish or subscribe data to particular topic. So those kind of permissions are provided to your device. So you simply configure your device, and this is just we are kind of using as a client to publish data to data stream, and we'll come back to this later. So far you created a device thing, and then you configure its certificate and policy. Now we need to create an IoT role. So when my device publishes the data to IoT core, we need to create a role which can route this data to the Kinesis data stream. And that's what we are going to do next. So simply go to the IoT core menu, click on the rules, create a Dozer rule. And then what we are saying here is that there's a topic called IoT/Dojo inbound, and we are saying that this is the topic where the message will be published by the device, and then if any message comes to this topic, simply now pick that message in this rule. So we are not doing any filter condition here, saying everything coming to this topic star, I want to pick as a part of the rule. And then what happens is that says, okay, fine. So I know where to look the message from. Then what action you want to perform? So you click on the add action, and then you have a big list of actions, and it just keep growing every day almost. But here the one we are interested is that we want to send this message to a Kinesis stream. So we simply select that one. And then all we do on the next step is simply provide the name of the stream and then partition key, and then simply select the role which will be used, which will authorize the IoT to publish data. We do that and configure it. So basically what we are doing in this particular step is that we are creating a rule in IoT so that when the device publishes a message to IoT core to a topic, we have a rule which can pick that data and route to Kinesis data stream for the storage. Okay, simple. Next, we are going to configure the glue part. So we have created the data store, Kinesis data stream. We have created the whole publisher part, which can publish data to this stream. Now let's create the ETL side of the story. So we go to the next step. So what happens in order to create a glue job? Glue job needs to interface with the source. So it does not interface with Kinesis directly. Programmatically you can do that, but why to write code if we can do that in configuration? So what we are going to do here is that we are going to create a data catalog in Glue, which will act as a source or catalog for the Kinesis data. Okay, so what Glue will do, Glue will talk to the catalog, and this catalog is nothing, it represents the data inside your Kinesis data string as a catalog, as a table. So first thing first, we'll go and create a database inside Glue, which is a Dojo database. Okay, and once we have created a database, we'll create a table, and in this case we'll create the manual table. So generally people do crawler. A crawler works on data sources like, at present, because things are changing and it can change anytime for more data sources. But right now, the crawler works for relational databases, S3, DynamoDB, and those kind of sources. And our data source is Kinesis at this point of time. So we simply manually add this table. So we simply say, okay, I want to add the table manually. Give nice a table name called Dojo table, then say, okay, what is your source? And you say Kinesis is my source. So you can see that Kinesis and Kafka has been added as two more sources as a data source to support the streaming data. So you select Kinesis as a data source. Then it says, okay, in what format your data will be? And we are saying it's going to be JSON format because I plan to publish data in JSON format for this workshop. Then say, okay, what is the schema you are going to provide? So I have got this kind of message in place, like it is a JSON document with three fields: sensor, temperature, vibration. So I'm going to send message like this. So we need to create a schema which can match to it. And it's pretty straightforward, guys. Simply what we have to do, we have to take each of these nodes and simply put a column against that. So for instance, first we added sensor as a column, which is string type. Next we add temperature and vibration as a column, and both are integer type. So you can see that you had three nodes as a part of your JSON document or the message which is coming from the device, and you have got three columns and their data types. So this table, once you finish it, it actually represents a catalog for the streaming data stored inside your Kinesis data stream. Now it is time to write the glue job, because glue job actually talks to the data catalog. So we go on the Glue console, we go and click on the jobs and say, okay, I want to add a new job. Then you provide a nice name to the job. You provide the role which you created earlier for the Glue job. In this case, you say, I want to actually AWS to generate this script for me. So I'm not going to write my own script. I want AWS to generate this script. And then you also provide the folder where you want to store the script. And if you remember, this is the folder we created, or a bucket and folder we created in the earlier steps. Then once you have done this basic configuration, you move next. It says, okay, what is your source table? And we simply select Dojo table. And this is a table we created in the earlier step, which represents the data inside your Kinesis data stream. So we provide that as a source table. Then on the next screen, say, okay, what do you want to do? Or say, I want to change the schema, because our job, what we're thinking is that we convert this JSON document to a CSV format, yeah, as an example over here. So say, I want to change the schema. And when you move next, Actually, it says, okay, fine. So how do you want, when you change the schema, what do you want? So say I want to create a table as a target. Say, okay, tell me the location of the target. So we are saying, okay, my location is Amazon S3. This is the bucket where I want my data to go. And this is the format I want my data to go. So remember, my source data is coming into CSV. And what we are saying here is that convert that CSV, that JSON into CSV. My source data coming to JSON, and I want that JSON data to be converted to CSV as a part of the job. So I say my format is CSV. I simply go and save, I save and hit the job. And then actually on the next column, in fact, it shows you that this is the mapping I'm doing, and this is the target columns I will create, data types. You can simply say, okay, let's use by default everything. And you save and edit the job. So once you have saved and edited the job, actually, you can simply go and run the job. Because remember, this job has to continuously run to keep looking for your streaming data coming into your Kinesis data stream. So you simply, you save your job and then you simply run the job. And it takes a while before the job started running. And the way you can find out is that the moment your execution time changes to something more than 0 seconds. So right now it's 0 seconds. That means my job has actually, my resource is not ready. My server behind the scene, which will do the actual execution, has not yet started. Okay. So, but moment it gets started, this number start ticking. And then the moment you see more than 0 seconds, you know that okay, your server is ready. Now you can stream data and it will automatically take care of. So you make sure that your job has successfully started. Now it is time to go and publish the data. And for publishing data, what we will do is that we'll go back to IoT, and then IoT has got a simulator MQTT client just for testing purposes, okay? So we simply click on the test menu on the left-hand side. It will open the MQTT client. And then in this, we'll simply go and say, I want to publish to a topic. And then remember this Dozo inbound, this was a topic where the IoT rule is looking for masses to come in, which it will route to the Kinesis data stream. So what we are saying here is, what we're doing here is that we are publishing this sample document to this particular topic. Yeah. And this is the same document format we have used. We have configured our data catalog to look data from the data format point of view. So we simply start publishing this message. And what I did for this, you go for 5-10 times. And just to say, okay, you can do one also, but if you create more, then you get an idea. So what happens is that you simply publish the message. So what happens when you publish this message to topic, the message goes to the topic, then we have got an IoT rule, which simply reads the message from the topic, and then it will route it to Kinesis data stream. And then we have a glue job continuously running, looking for data inside glue job, data stream. It will read data from data stream, transform from JSON to CSV format, and write to the S3 bucket. That will have to happen automatically behind the scene. Okay, so all you have to do is simply publish the data, give it a go, like a minute or so, and then you can go to your S3 bucket and you will see your data is already created. So what happens is generally, Glue has an automatic way of partitioning data by year, month, day, and hour, and you can change the partition the way you want, but I didn't bother at this point of time. So if you go and drill down to this whole folder structure behind, you will see this is your bucket, then year, month, day, hour, and then you can see your file over here. And if you open this file, you'll see it's the same data, but now it is converted from a JSON format to a CSV format. So this shows you end-to-end integration of streaming data coming from IoT device to all the way to S3 bucket and all this transformation happening in between. So that very much ends the workshop. One last step and very important one is to clean up all the resources you use for the workshop. Otherwise, you might incur cost even if you are done with the workshop. And essentially what you do, each of the resources you created in this workshop, you have to delete one by one. So delete the databases, job, S3 bucket, your IoT rule, device, policy, certificate, your Kinesis data stream and roles. And once you delete all those things, actually your account has been reset to where you started. Okay, so that finishes the workshop. You hope you like it. And if you go to, for instance, if you go to AWS Dojo, here you can find many other workshops similar to this, each implementing a particular scenario. And there are many exercises like this, which again, help you build something. And in process of that, you can learn about AWS services. So if you like button, if you like, then click on the like button. Please subscribe to our channel. And if you have any feedback, suggestions, or you want us to build some kind of workshop exercise for you, which is your need, then please write us on our YouTube channel comment box, or you can also send the message through our contact us form. That's all for today. Hope you liked it, and please provide your feedback if yes, if not also, and have a nice day. Okay, bye-bye.